As someone who has seen a wealth of anime, it should come as no surprise that I have a rather long list of shows I've been meaning to discuss on this channel. Usually I just group them together based on their genre or theme, but that doesn't always allow me to talk about the shows I want to. So, as you've probably already guessed from the title of this video, I've decided to recommend a random assortment of anime that have very little in common with each other, just so that I can finally mention them. Enjoy! Ascendance of a Bookworm revolves around a diligent book-loving college student, and soon-to-be librarian, whose life is cut tragically short following an unforeseen accident. Awakening in the frail body of a 5-year-old girl, in a world where books are scarce, her memories of her former life return, and she becomes determined to create and print her very own books so that she may read once again. It didn't take me very long to fall in love with this anime, as its story, world-building, and characters captivated me from the very beginning. It's a bit of a slow burn, as it goes through the trouble of showcasing every step of the bookmaking process, setbacks and all, whilst also carefully fleshing out its world and characters, but it's this aspect that makes this anime so engrossing. Its visual presentation is its only real downfall, as it looks a little rough, and gives off a strong impression that it didn't have a particularly large budget. Of course, this doesn't stop the anime from being fantastic, but considering how good the story is, it would have been nice to have seen the show be given a little more polish. It's a truly magnificent anime that I encourage everyone to check out. Astra Lost in Space is another brilliant anime that for some reason fell under most people's radar. Set in the year 2063, the anime tells the story of a group of students as they depart for their week-long planetary camp. However, upon reaching their campsite, things take a drastic turn for the worse, as a mysterious orb transports them into the depths of space. Discovering an abandoned spaceship nearby, the students decide to use it to return home, but along the way, they realize the stakes of their journey are far higher than they could have imagined. Despite the perilous situation these characters find themselves in, Astra Lost in Space manages to remain surprisingly light-hearted throughout most of its adventure. There's a strong sense of camaraderie between its main cast that ensures that no matter how bad things get, they've always got each other's backs, which is an aspect I liked a lot. It's also a complete story, so you don't have to worry about being left on a cliffhanger, though some have argued that the pacing suffers a little because of it. I, however, am not one of those people. If the idea of a fun, relatively light-hearted sci-fi adventure sounds appealing to you, then I'd highly recommend giving this anime a shot. Inuyashiki is a sci-fi psychological thriller about a compassionate old man who's distraught to learn that he's dying of cancer. Unfortunately, his family feels indifferent towards him, which leads to an emotional breakdown in a nearby field, where he is struck by an explosion of extraterrestrial origin. When he comes to, he discovers that he's been reborn as a mechanized weapon and dedicates himself to doing good. However, a high schooler who was nearby was also reborn and chooses a much more sinister path, leading to an inevitable clash between the two. It's rare to have an elderly person as the main protagonist, but it's a welcome inclusion that gives the anime a unique charm and also helps to differentiate the two main characters' actions, as they each have different perspectives and life experiences. Like Astra Lost in Space, this is a complete story, but it has fewer episodes to work with, leading to some very tight pacing that some people weren't keen on. The ideological clash between good and evil isn't exactly original, but it's easy enough to follow, and there's some good tension building and escalation that helps to keep the viewer on the edge of their seat. I don't really see many people talking about this anime anymore, but I really enjoyed it, and it was one of my favourites to air in 2017. Fruits Basket follows an orphaned high school girl who's left to live in a tent after a family tragedy leaves her all alone. When her temporary home is discovered by the mysterious Soma clan, she suddenly finds herself moving in with them, but she soon learns that their family has a bizarre secret. When hugged by a member of the opposite sex, they transform into animals of the zodiac. Fruits Basket starts off like any typical shoujo anime, but thankfully it doesn't stick to its genre's conventions for very long. What makes this anime so captivating is that it manages to introduce compelling characters and then further adds depth to them by carefully exploring their individual backstories in a meaningful and impactful way. It starts off fairly light-hearted, before slowly introducing more serious drama, and it does it in a way that doesn't feel particularly forced or overly melodramatic. I'm specifically recommending the 2019 remake over the 2001 original, as not only does this new series look a lot better, it's also a lot more faithful to the source material, and is also a complete adaptation as well. It's also really good, if I hadn't already made that clear, with the second and third seasons really ramping things up. It's easily one of the best shoujo animes ever made, so you're doing yourself a great disservice by not checking it out. Run with the Wind revolves around a former ace runner who finds himself on hard times. After being chased away from a convenience store for shoplifting, he's quickly pursued by a senior from his university who is impressed by his agility. Having nowhere else to go, he's persuaded to move into an old dormitory, where he's introduced to 8 other students. It's here that he learns of his senior's plans to enter the Hakone Ekiden, a prominent university relay marathon. But with so few of them having any real running experience, simply qualifying will prove to be an uphill struggle. Run with the Wind is about as conventional as a sports anime can get, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. It's probably one of the easiest anime to recommend to those that typically avoid this genre, as it's not based on a sport that has a lot of rules to follow, so you don't need to have any prior knowledge to get into it. The anime features a decently large cast of compelling characters, and they're each given time in the spotlight so that none of them ever feel disposable. The individual growth of each character is perhaps the most significant part of this anime, as they all work hard to achieve their shared goal, despite each of them having a different level of athletic prowess. Overall, while it doesn't do anything particularly earth-shattering, it manages to deliver a polished and all-around entertaining package that's well worth the watch. Stars Align tells the story of a boys' soft tennis club on the brink of disbandment. Its captain, wishing to avoid this outcome, seeks the help of a reluctant transfer student and old friend in order to help improve the club's track record. As they work together to save their club, the boys must also overcome their own personal hardships. Like Run with the Wind, Stars Align has a pretty straightforward plot that won't surprise anyone familiar with sports anime, but what sets it apart is its focus on the interpersonal struggles of its main cast. This gives the anime a kind of gritty realism to it that's fairly uncommon for this genre, as these are not teenagers with happy or perfect families. It also has some great LGBTQ representation, which I wasn't expecting, but very much appreciated. However, as much as I enjoyed what's here, it's only fair to point out that this story is incomplete, and considering this is an original anime, there isn't currently any way to get the rest of the story. For those who aren't aware, Stars Align was originally supposed to have 24 episodes, but the production committee cut their episode count in half at the last minute, and they didn't have time to rework the story into just 12 episodes, so instead they opted to tell just half the story. What's here is definitely worth checking out, but be prepared to be left on a rather abrupt cliffhanger that may never be resolved. Tsuritama follows a socially awkward high school student who's unable to make any long-lasting friendships due to his grandmother's career, which requires frequent relocation. His social anxiety is so bad that whenever he becomes nervous, he ends up experiencing a sensation similar to drowning. Upon settling into a charming seaside town, he meets an eccentric transfer student who claims to be an alien. Soon after, he becomes entangled with a secluded young fisherman, as well as an Indian prince and his pet duck, as the self-proclaimed alien tasks them with an absurd mission to save the world from a mysterious threat in the ocean. While Tsuritama is categorized as a sports anime, it leans much more towards being a slice-of-life anime, as it takes on a very different structure to most. There's no grand tournament arc, or fierce rival team to compete against. Instead, the anime embraces its fishing theme to the fullest, by being a much slower paced and calmer type of anime, where the primary focus is on the development of its quirky cast of characters and their budding friendships. It's a highly underrated show that deserves far more love and attention than it currently gets, so please consider checking it out if you haven't already done so. Dusk, Maiden of Amnesia is a story of a female ghost who mysteriously died in the basement of an old school building. Having no memories of her former life, or how she died, she discreetly forms the Paranormal Investigations Club in search of answers. After a chance encounter with a freshman who is able to see her, the two soon grow close, as he decides to help her uncover the truth surrounding her death. While it's listed on some websites as a horror anime, I didn't personally find this anime to be all that scary. It has its moments, but the horror elements are largely kept to a minimum, as the main focus is on the mystery and romance. Dusk Maiden of Amnesia definitely has a weird side to it, as it's far from being a conventional romance anime, but that's precisely what makes it so interesting. The first episode alone was enough to draw me in, thanks in part to how they chose to introduce the characters. It's a perfect example of show don't tell, as it manages to communicate to the audience what's going on, without needing to explicitly explain it. Also, you don't get many mystery romance anime, where both the mystery and romance are satisfying, which is another reason to give this one a watch. Three Leaves, Three Colors tells the story of a pampered rich girl who's thrown into poverty after her father's company collapses. While eating bread crusts alone one day, she's introduced to an energetic girl with an insatiable appetite, along with a calm and often direct girl who has a sadistic personality. All three of them share the kanji for leaf in their name, and begin an unlikely friendship as they try to balance the everyday challenges that high school life and adolescence have to offer. Three Leaves, Three Colors looks about as generic as a cute girls doing cute things anime can get, but there are three things that help to set this one apart. Its characters, its high production values, and its comedy. Unlike your typical cute girls doing cute things anime, the cast of Three Leaves Three Colors is unique, to say the least. Each of the main girls has a distinctive personality that works well with the show's comedy to create something that I found to be highly entertaining, and its supporting cast is just as fun and likable as its main protagonists. The anime also boasts an impressive amount of fluidity and bounciness to its animation that really helps to bring these characters to life, and further accentuates the show's comedic elements. As someone who finds the cute girls doing cute things genre to be pretty hit or miss, I was pleasantly surprised by this show, and would highly recommend giving it a watch. Finally, there's Scum's Wish, a very polarizing anime about a teenage couple who are both in love with other people that they cannot be with. In order to starve off their loneliness from their respected unrequited loves, they decide to use each other as a substitute, satisfying their emotional and sexual desires with the understanding that they'll terminate their relationship if their love is returned by the people they're infatuated with. Scum's Wish is a rather unconventional romance anime, as it deals with people in situations that aren't particularly pleasant. As such, there's a very clear line between those that enjoy this anime and those that don't. Despite that, I still wanted to include this anime, not just because I'm one of those that did actually enjoy it, but because it's a great example of a romance anime doing something different. For those out there that have convinced themselves that all romance anime are the same, and that they don't enjoy this genre, then I suggest giving Scum's Wish a watch. The anime features grittier romantic situations than your typical romance anime, and because of that, it feels more realistic. It's definitely not the type of anime that is going to appeal to everyone, but regardless, I'd still recommend checking it out. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more like it in the future, then be sure to subscribe to my channel so that new videos are delivered directly to your subscription box. Be sure to check out some of my other videos if you'd like to see more anime recommendations, and feel free to leave a like and a comment to show your support. It truly means a lot.